Christ had risen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Happy Easter. Our readings today can be found on page 88 of Breaking Bread. Welcome all who are visiting with us at St. Jane DeChantal Parish special day. Whether family returning or friends visiting or just passing through. For today, we are all part of our larger Catholic family celebrating the resurrection. As respect to the liturgy, please turn off all communication devices. Our celebrant today is Father Joseph Paul. Can you put yourself in the shoes of the woman and disciples who visited the tomb on that precious morning? They had just witnessed the death of the Lord days earlier. They still had not understood that he must arise to fulfill the prophets. Would you too not think his body was stolen? We know the full story of the greatest story ever told. Our readings today tell us that Christ has risen and defeated death. His sacrifice was not in vain. Without the resurrection, we would still have no promise of eternal life through Christ. Easter eggs, baskets of candy, Easter hymn are all wonderful things to help us celebrate. But open your heart and ears today and listen to our readings for the reason of the celebration. Christ has risen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 167. Let us now stand, lift our voices together as we sing our entrance hymn found in number 167 in Breaking Bread or 593 in Ritual Song. Jesus Christ is risen today. Number 167 in Breaking Bread or 593 in Ritual Song.
Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The joy and peace of the risen Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
The past 40 days you've been journeying with our Lord to Calvary. Ride in the glory of this Easter day. With confidence we ask God for the forgiveness of our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the everlasting judge of the living and the dead. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you reconcile sinners to the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the hope of your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
O God, who on this day, for your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, may through the renewal brought by your Spirit rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading of the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with them after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people, and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. Amen." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, do you know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened, for our paschal lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth, the word of the Lord.
Amen.
The sequence. Christians, to the paschal victim, offer your thankful praises, a lamb, a sheep redeems. Christ, who only is sinless, reconciles sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended in the combat as pendants. The Prince of Life, who died, reigns immortal. Speak, Mary declaring, what you saw wayfaring, the tomb of Christ, who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection. Bright angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope, is arising. To Galilee he goes before you. Christ indeed from death is risen, a new life obtained. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reign. Amen. Hallelujah. Word of the Lord.
I accidentally hit the Easter Bunny and killed him.
There may not be an Easter Bunny because of me. What should I do? The woman told the man not to cry. She knew exactly what to do. She went into the car trunk. She pulled out a spray can. She walked over to the limp, dead bunny, sprayed over the entire contents of the can into the little furry animal. And miraculously, the Easter Bunny came back to life, jumped up and picked up the spilled eggs, waved his paw at the two humans, and hopped down the road. 50 yards away, the Easter Bunny stopped, turned around, waved, and hopped down the road another 50 yards. Turned, waved, hopped another 50 yards, and so on. The man was astonished. He said to the woman, "What in heaven's name is your spray can? What was it that you sprayed on the Easter Bunny?" And the woman turned the can around to the man who greeted the label and said, "Hair spray restores life to dead hair, also as a permanent wig." It was worth waiting for that, wasn't it? See what you miss when you're not here? Come on, folks. It's so good to see this church jam-packed. We miss you all week. Please make it a point to come every Sunday. Enjoy this beautiful worship experience we have here at St. James. We truly, truly miss you. How many more miles do we have to go, Dad? How much longer before we get to where we're going? Don't these questions call to mind those trips in the family car, where the trip was barely just begun and the questions arise from the peanut gallery in the van? Questions usually continue every 10 minutes or so until someone in the front seat blows his or her top and says, "Yes, kids, we have reached our destination." In a similar way, all of us have been on a journey for 40 days. And for some individuals, last night at the Easter Vigil, it was the culmination of a lifelong journey to the Catholic Church. And we may have grown impatient along the way, and we thought that Easter would never arrive. Doesn't Lent seem eternal? We start out on Ash Wednesday, but eventually we get there. We do arrive at our destination. And all of us have been on a journey of Lent. We faced our indifferences, our sinfulness, and sought to be reconciled with God and neighbor. And during this time, accepted those disciplines of prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. And we'll soon renew the vows of our baptism and renounce Satan and all his works. Confess our faith in the risen Lord. What the first disciples saw at the Easter morning was an empty tomb, and they assumed that someone robbed the grave. Robbing of the grave to obtain the burial shroud, the clothing, and the jewelry of the deceased was a common practice. Of our Lord. First thought would render one's mind upon seeing the empty tomb was not resurrection, but somebody robbed the grave of Jesus. It was only when Simon Peter and the other disciple had entered the tomb and examined the evidence of the wrappings, they suspected something more than a robbery was involved here. The beloved disciple saw and believed that Christ had risen. The resurrection of Christ, my friends, is more than an event which took place 2,000 years ago in Jerusalem. Because Christ rises again whenever he's able to impart or share the new life he won by his resurrection. In baptism, by which Jesus begins to live in one of God's creatures, we die with Christ's original sin. In the waters of baptism, we rise and share an eternal life. In any act of reconciliation in which the lost line of love is restored, we say, "I am sorry, please forgive me." How often do we fail to take a close look at our lives and discover the power of the resurrection? Like the disciples who saw the empty tomb, we're confused by all the suffering, pain, and death that seem to pervade our lives and our world. Look back at our lives and discover the blessing and the crosses we've shouldered in life. We need to come to the risen Christ, lifting us out of the pain and transform our lives. The hardships we encounter during our time on earth will be part of the process of rising to new life in Christ. The resurrection is power for us. because it's our assurance that Christ is alive and well with us always. Today, Christ cannot be seen in his risen life, but he must be seen and heard and touched in us. We have to ask, in our intimacy at times, that we're able to recognize the risen Christ in our lives. We now have that opportunity to show others in a way in which to live, to do business, to bring justice, and to work for peace. Christ has given us the strength to build this kingdom. Jesus wants us to bring to others the joy and peace that comes to us this day. To be like him, risen and glorified at every moment of our lives. Teacher asked a second grade class one day what each wanted to be when they grew up. Some said a football player, a doctor, a policeman, a fireman, an astronaut, a teacher. Every second grader responded, except Timmy. And Timmy just sat quietly in his place. So the teacher asked him, Timmy, what do you want to be when you grow up? Possible. Possible? Asked the confused teacher. Possible, Timmy said. Timmy, what do you mean you want to be possible? Well, Timmy explained, my mom was always telling me that I'm impossible. So when I get big, I want to be possible. My friends, Easter is the great feast of possibilities. That Christ enables us to make possible our own lives, all that he taught and lived throughout his grief life among us. That love, that compassion, generosity, humility, and selflessness, that we always think of others, not so much ourselves. Hatred, prejudice, despair, terrorism, greed, and death. The empty tomb is a sign of a perfect hope. That in Christ all things are possible, that we can make of our lives we want them to be. We come, the people that God created us to become. The question I need for you to consider is, will you give God that chance to work for you? Please stand now for the renewal of our baptismal promises. Dear friends, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so we rise with him to new life. Now that we have completed our Lenten retreat, let us renew the promises we made in baptism when we rejected Satan and his works, and promise to serve God faithfully all our days in his holy Roman Catholic Church. So I ask all baptized believers, you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children.
I do.
Reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin.
I do.
You reject Satan, the father of sin and the prince of darkness.
I do.
You believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I do.
Believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father.
I do.
Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
I do.
God, the all-powerful Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and forgiven all our sins. May also keep us faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, this may rejoice and pray now for the needs of Holy Mother Church.
That the Church may manifest concrete ways the truth of Christ triumphant over death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the gloom of malice and evil may yield to a springtime of sincerity and truth for all peoples of earth during this Easter season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and confirmed will find in the Church the meaning and happiness for which their hearts long, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will touch the sick with his love, mercy, especially Cardinal George, Stephanie Pollock, Irene Jib, Len Huffman, Pat Lampin, Rosalie Nunez, Carl Kubilda, Michael Garcia, Lauren Mandel, and all those in our prayer list, we pray to the Lord. That those in life believe Jesus to be the Christ, the Son of God, may now rejoice and be glad in God's steadfast love that endures forever, especially those Christians, Mark Myrtle in Kenya, Shirley Brunner, Katie Kara, Tadus Kosiski, and those who mourn their loss, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Kathleen Cheney, Patricia Dory, Mary McCowell, Rafaela Maldonado, and healing blessings for Daniel, who are remembering the priest's special intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we rejoice in the great work you have accomplished for your Son, Jesus Christ. Fill us with zeal to proclaim this good news, and graciously hear all these our prayers through the same Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Of the Holy Spirit, all glory.
accept it, transfigured into the body and blood of Christ our Lord. As we come forward to receive the food of eternal life, let us sing our communion hymn, number 914, ritual song, our little sacred Jesus, number 914, and ritual song.
God bless you, Father, Son,